In the day's other news, the U.S. reached 400,000 deaths from COVID-19, nearly equal to the number of Americans killed in World War II. 100,000 of those occurred just in the past month. Meanwhile, a panel commissioned by the World Health Organization criticized the agency for not declaring a global emergency sooner. One panel member, former Liberian President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, said that the WHO needs more enforcement power.
Member states are looking at WHO for leadership, coordination, and guidance, but are not equipping it with the authority, the access, or the funding needed to provide that.
The panel also criticized China and other nations for failing to act earlier on the pandemic. President-elect Biden had an emotional departure from his home state of Delaware today on the eve of his inauguration. It happened at a National Guard headquarters named for his elder son, Beau, who died of brain cancer in 2015. Mr. Biden noted the significance and then choked up.
General Biden, it's deeply personal that our next journey to Washington starts here, a place that defines the very best of who we are as Americans. Well, excuse the emotion, but when I die, Delaware will be written on my heart.
Later, the Bidens arrived at Joint Base Andrews outside Washington. They'll spend the night at Blair House, the president's official guest residence, before moving into the White House tomorrow. Mr. Biden will offer a sweeping immigration bill right after being sworn in. It's expected to provide an 8-year path to citizenship for some 11 million people living in the U.S. illegally. The nominee for Secretary of Homeland Security, Alejandro Mayorkas, said today that the plan would fix a broken system. The incoming Senate Majority Leader says that an impeachment trial of President Trump will be a priority once Democrats take control tomorrow. By then, Mr. Trump will be out of office. And Senator Chuck Schumer confirmed today that he wants to keep it that way.
There will be an impeachment trial in the United States Senate. There will be a vote on convicting the president for high crimes and misdemeanors. And if the president is convicted, there will be a vote on barring him from running again.
Before a trial can begin, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has to send over the impeachment article passed by the House, charging Mr. Trump with inciting an insurrection. She has not said yet when that will happen. A federal appeals court today struck down President Trump's rollback of emissions curbs for coal-fired power plants. The curbs were imposed under the Obama administration, but the three-judge panel found the Trump move was a fundamental misreading of the law. And on Wall Street, stocks rose on hopes for new economic stimulus in a Biden administration. The Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 116 points to close at 30,930. The NASDAQ rose 198 points, and the S&P 500 added 30. Still to come on the NewsHour on this final day, we examine the lasting legacy of the Trump presidency. The hundreds of thousands of Americans lost to COVID-19 are memorialized on the National Mall. And mental health struggles among college students rise dramatically amid the ongoing pandemic.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.